How's it going, guys? It's Dr. Bion, or Dr. B, from Mental Health Nation. Now, do you want to have a smaller brain? Do you want to take a look at an MRI of your head and see a brain that looks like the size of a peanut, like Homer Simpson? Do you want to have a harder time remembering and learning things? Well, I'm going to give you the exact recipe in doing just that. Or if you don't want to do that, and be wise in doing the opposite. So what causes some of the things I just said? Believe it or not, it's stress. It's increased stress. We all know stress sucks, but how many of us know that stress can actually shrink or cause our brain to be atrophied over time? Now, this first phenomenon was seen in patients or people with PTSD, where specifically a part of the brain called the hippocampus shrunk significantly in these people. Now, the hippocampus is an area deep within the brain involved with memory and learning. So it was no surprise that these people also suffered from memory loss. It's also no surprise that people with Alzheimer's, that actually begins in the hippocampus, is notorious and famous for affecting memory. So how is this all happening on a biochemical, a microscopic level? It's actually cortisol. When we're stressed, cortisol is sent out by the adrenal glands, which are like baseball caps sitting on top of our kidneys. Now, this cortisol is often released with negative emotions like stress, but can also happen with things like depression and anxiety as well. And normally, this cortisol is supposed to help us remember important or emotionally relevant things, you know, like to not put our fingers on the stove or to not, you know, put our hands inside the mouth of dangerous dogs or things like that. So it's supposed to help us remember things. And this is why people with PTSD often have vivid memories, you know, vivid recurring memories of certain traumatic events, you know, or experiences that they went through. So it should be no surprise that the hippocampus has one of the highest levels of cortisol receptors in the brain, and why people who are depressed, who again can often feel stressed, have a higher proportion of memory loss. Okay, so the bottom line is a little cortisol is fine, completely normal, but in this day and age, with the amount of stress that the average person is enduring, you know, in these busy cities, it's a delicate balance that often goes out of whack. Now, the brain is a delicate organ, so overstimulation of any kind of way, including stress, can be hazardous for the neurons and the interconnections. So overbearing your brain, you know, at times with anything from toxins to MSG to stress, etc., heavy metals, is not a good idea. You know, stress and those other things can actually increase free radicals in the body and the brain, and these free radicals over time can damage and even destroy brain connections, if not cells themselves. So this is one of the primary reasons to why brain shrinkage can be seen in many neurological diseases like Alzheimer's, depression, schizophrenia, and PTSD in particular. So if you're prone to stress, there is some good news, okay? There is some good news. That's why I'm making this video and that's why I'm here, okay? A lot of this process can be reversible. Of course, I can tell you, you know, to avoid stress or, you know, don't be stressed out, you know, these cliche things, but what does that really do? So instead, I would much rather give you some easy to follow, you know, tangible recommendations instead. Okay, so I'm gonna do that. But first and foremost, it's important to note that a large number of studies have shown that antioxidants, you know, especially from the diet, can protect us from brain harmful stress-induced effects, okay? So how do we up our antioxidant levels? Number one, I know you don't, you know, people don't really like to hear it, but it's gonna come from our diet, mainly vegetables and fruits, okay? The more colorful the vegetable, the more antioxidants it'll have in general. And I say vegetables first because fruits can be jam-packed with sugars, which kind of, you know, hinders some of their effects. But step number one, we'll be using a high-quality multivitamin, okay? So vitamins are antioxidants inherently, especially the B vitamins are very neuroprotective. For example, riboflavin, a B vitamin, has been shown to increase brain cell function and reduce free radicals in the brain. So, you know, if you're serious about your health, I would lean towards higher quality, which are usually more expensive supplements, in this case, multivitamins. So I would avoid, you know, gummies and things like that. Number two will be an antioxidant called curcumin. Now, curcumin is the active ingredient of turmeric, you know, of the Indian spice turmeric, the yellow, potent yellow herb. And curcumin is the number one anti-cancer, natural compound in the world. Okay, it's pretty much up there with many anti-cancer medications, you know, without the side effects. Well, the Journal of Experimental Neurology found that it dramatically improved synaptic plasticity, you know, which is involved with healing, memory and learning, and anything else constructive with the brain. Number three will be an antioxidant called quercetin. Now, you can get quercetin in a supplement, or you can boost your diet with green and white teas to have more of a quercetin punch. Now, quercetin can also be found in onions and apples as well. Next one will be fish oil. Now, fish oil has been shown to reduce brain inflammation, and if you've seen any of my videos, I'm a big proponent of omega-3s, especially animal-based omega-3s like fish oil. And lastly for this video, it'll be getting regular, moderate physical activity or exercise. Okay, exercise increases the amount of endorphins in the brain. Endorphins are natural painkillers that make us feel better and decrease our stress. Exercise also increases BDNF levels, brain-derived neurotrophic factor levels in the brain, which have been shown to be anti-inflammatory as well. And if you want to learn more about BDNF, definitely check out my video on that. So I may actually be offering personalized one-on-one health coaching sessions in the future. Now, if this sounds like something you would be interested in, leave a comment below just so I can gauge how much interest, if any, there is, and if it would be worth, you know, setting my time aside to helping people with that. For everyone else, thank you for watching all the way till the end. Hope you got something out of it, at least one thing. That's my goal with all these videos. And subscribe to my YouTube channel, Mental Health Nation, for more videos in the future. Thanks again. I'm Dr. Bion, like Bionic, and welcome to the real Mental Health Nation. Till next time.